In May 2016, Taylor Weyeneth was an undergraduate at John University in New York, a legal study student and fraternity member who organized a golf tournament and other events to raise money for veterans and their family. Less than a year later, at 23, Weyeneth was a political appointee and rising star at the Office of National Drug Control Policy, the White House office responsible for coordinating the federal government multi-billion dollar anti-drug initiative and supporting President Donald Trump's efforts to stop the opioid epidemic. Weyeneth would soon become deputy chief of staff. Weyeneth's brief biography of a few clues that he would so quickly assume a leading role in the drug policy office, a job recently occupied by a lawyer and a veteran government official. His only professional experience after college and before becoming an appointee was working on Trump's presidential campaign. Weyeneth ascended from a low-level post to deputy chief of staff is doing lot but to staff turnover and vacancy. The story of his appointment and remarkable rise provide insight into the Trump administration, political appointment and the troubled state of the drug policy office. Trump has pledged to marshal federal government talent and resources to address the opioid crisis, but nearly a year after his inauguration, the Drug Policy Office, known as ONDCP, lacked a permanent director. At least 7 of his administration appointees have departed. Office spokesman William Eason said among them was the General Counsel and Acting Chief of Staff, some of whose duties were assumed by Weyeneth. According to a memo obtained by the Washington Post, ONDCP leadership recognizes that we have lost a few talented staff members and that the organization would benefit from an infusion of new expert staff, said the Yan Ba memo from Acting Director Richard Baum, a civil servant. The function of the Chief of Staff will be picked up by me and the Deputy Chief of Staff. Weyeneth, 24, did not respond to requests for an interview after being contacted by the Post about Weyeneth's qualification and about inconsistency on his resume. An administration official said Weyeneth will return to the position he initially held in the agency as a White House liaison for ONDCP, a job that typically involved working with outside interest group. The official, who agreed to speak only on the condition of anonymity, said that Weyeneth has been primarily performing administrative work rather than making policy decision, and that he had assumed additional duty and an additional title following staff opening. The office hired Weyeneth in March after seeing his passion and commitment on the issue of opioid and drug addiction, the official said. The official and Weyeneth's mother both said Weyeneth was moved by the death of a relative several years ago from a heroin overdose. The Office of National Drug Control Policy was started by Congress in 1988 with passage of the Anti-Drug Abuse Act, part of the White House Executive Office. The ONDCP director, often referred to as the drug czar, is supposed to be the president's main advisor on issues relating to illicit drugs, including manufacturing, smuggling, and addiction. In addition to its responsibility for coordinating drug programs at other federal agencies, ONDCP is supposed to produce the National Drug Control Strategy, an annual blueprint for drug policy. The office also administer grant to law enforcement and drug free community program for the budget year that began in October. The White House budget plan call for $18.4 million in spending for 65 employees at ONDCP, excluding people detailed from the military and other areas of government, and program spending of $350 million last year the office of management and budget proposed cut that would have effectively eliminated the UNDCP for the fiscal year that began in October. The White House abandoned the plan after objection from a bipartisan group of senators in October. Trump nominee to lead the office prep Tom Marino, ERPA, withdrew from consideration after a joint investigation by the Post and 60 Minutes found he had sponsored legislation favoring opioid makers and upping the ability of the Drug Enforcement Administration to investigate abuses. Current and former UNDCP officials who have served under Democratic and Republican presidents said in interview that the turmoil, including the elevation of violence, hinder efforts to rally the government at a time when the nation is going through the worst opioid crisis in its history. It sent a terrible message, said Gil Kulikowski, a former Seattle police chief who ran the office during the Obama administration, and he is a former commissioner of Customs and Border Protection. It's a message that we're not taking this drug issue seriously. John Walter, the office's director in the administration of George W. Bush, declined through a spokeswoman to comment the circumstances. Seize of Weyeneth appointment and rapid rise at UNDCP had not been reported previously to resume he submitted to the government or obtained through open record request by American Brit 21 Stone Century and another Democratic Cleaning Organization, which said them in response to inquiry. The White House released a third resume to the Post when he was in high school. Weyeneth was director of production for Chemistry, a family firm in Scarnito, New York, that specialist in processing cheeses and other health products. On resume said he served in that job from 2008 to 2013, and two other indicate he stopped working there in September 2011. In the summer and fall of 2011, the firm was secretly processing illegal steroids from China as part of a conspiracy involving people from Virginia, California and elsewhere in the United States and one person in China. Federal court record show Weyeneth's stepfather, Matthew Gregson, pleaded guilty to a felony conspiracy charge last year and received 2 years probation and a fine. Weyeneth was not charged in the investigation known as Operation Grasshopper. His mother, Kim Weyeneth, said in an interview that neither she nor her son knew about the steroid production and that he provided information to help the federal prosecutor. We didn't know anything that was going on, Kim Weyeneth said, adding that she and Taylor were excluded by Gretchen from a part of the facility where the steroid was kept. It's a very humongous plan. Kim Weyeneth said that she and Taylor were becoming estranged from Gretchen and that she is now seeking a divorce. Gretchen attorney Robert Austin said he relayed interview request from the Post, but Gretchen did not respond. In court last year, Gretchen said he did not understand the gravity of the scheme at the time but had come to appreciate that it was wrong. According to a court transcript, the actor Alec Baldwin, a cousin of Gretchen, wrote a letter to a judge asking for leniency. Baldwin said in an interview that Gretchen had raised Taylor Weyeneth. He said he was surprised Weyeneth went into politics because as far as he could tell from family gathering, there was a single molecule of political DNA in the household. Weyeneth attended St. John University in Queen. According to his resume, he joined a fraternity, worked part-time in various jobs and volunteered the Passionist Monastery in Queen. He enrolled in a master program at Fordham University in the Wrong. Author resume say MA Political Science at Fordham Center for Electoral Politics and Democracy. The first resume he submitted to the government provide no date for his graduate study, and the other two say he did his coursework from 2016 to June 2017. Fordham University spokesman Bob Howe told the Post that a student named Taylor Weyeneth is enrolled in the Graduate School of Art and Sciences at Fordham in a master program for electoral and campaign management. He has not completed his degree yet. In the first semester, Weyeneth said he volunteered for more than 275 hours at the monastery between 2012 and 2016. The second semester, he submitted to the government said it was more than 150 hours. The semester provided by the White House does not mention volunteer work at the monastery. Two monastery rectors, one current and one former, contacted by the Post did not dispute that Weyeneth volunteered there, but said they had no memory of him and no paperwork related to his volunteer work. The administration official who spoke on the condition of anonymity acknowledged that the first resume contained error. He said in later resume, Weyeneth included that referring to a master's degree as projection of when he expected to receive it after graduating from ST. John in May 2016, Weyeneth worked in a number of jobs for Trump presidential campaign, including coordinating voter services and arranging travel and temporary housing for senior campaign officials. He also worked directly with Rick Durbin, then director of Trump Transition Team on special projects, according to one of his resume. A spokesman said Durbin was not available for comment on January 23, 2017. Weyeneth joined the administration as an assistant at the Treasury Department. He was a general scale dù 11 employee, according to data maintained by ProPublica in the Washington area. A federal worker at that level last year generally earned between $66,510 and $86,459, according to government data. He moved to UNDCP in March, his resume show, and was named deputy chief of staff in July, according to his LinkedIn page. Under the Clinton, Bush and Obama administration, the office has attracted some prominent law enforcement, public health and military experts. Some recent deputy chief of staff had years of experience working in government or public policy before being appointed. Among them was Designer Label, a lawyer who served as deputy chief of staff, senior policy advisor and chief of staff at UNDCP during the Obama administration. She had previously served Multi-Justin S. Legal Counsel to the Seattle Mayor and taught Public Policy and Legislative Ethics at Seattle University. Label said the office must do well because no oil in government do law enforcement and public health officials come together to develop way to confront drug-related problem with the opioid crisis. The office should be vital. She said it requires an hands-on approach and that kind of approach can only be coordinated through the Office of National Drug Control Policy, she said.